C-SPAN report, folks.
Left the bike behind, hopped the fence, and ran. And then only had to wait while we drove out of town and rolled right over the trap. The vehicle I was riding in saved our lives. It was what's called a mine-resistant ambush protected truck, or an MRAP. And these days, it's the standard vehicle for any U.S. patrol that leaves the bases in Iraq and Afghanistan. It's a very tall, heavily armored vehicle with an angled body that helps deflect bomb blasts from underneath and from the side. The Pentagon began buying tens of thousands of these things, about $1 million a piece, back in 2007 and 2008, after IED casualties spiked in Iraq. Today, Iraq is not so much the problem, but after several years when Afghanistan didn't really have any IEDs, they are now the major killer of American troops in Afghanistan. Around half of Americans killed or seriously injured in Afghanistan are victims of IEDs. The Pentagon says there are around 1,300 IEDs discovered in Afghanistan every month, either by blowing up or being found beforehand. And that doesn't even count the ones that no one ever sees. So you're talking tens of thousands of IEDs every year of a bewildering variety, some of which you can detect, some of which are very hard to detect, and killing hundreds of American troops a year. It would be many more if we weren't spending billions of dollars on MRAP trucks. As it stands,
we have to do research into being able to detect these from the air and say, here's where they are, here's where they are. There's chemicals, there's steel, there's electronics. Don't tell me you can't detect that stuff in the ground with a short penetrating radar. They aren't buried that deep.
In Afghanistan, and most of those are since the IED scourge in that country really picked up over the last 3 years. IEDs are the major reason why the coalition cannot fully control even provinces close to Kabul, where they have the most troops. It's extremely difficult because of the IED threat just to get between two points in Afghanistan, to do it with any guarantee of safety at all. Although there's no perfect guarantee, requires the route clearance patrols, which also suffer their own casualties, because who's clearing the routes for them? So to do for the routine patrols to go out safely requires route clearance. There's often overhead surveillance.
We're going to take this risk, have the technology to control it. Or just don't go over there. Let them deal with their own IEDs.
Jam the signals that
leave, and what blows up is what blows up.
And then after the fact, whenever there's a blast, you have to call in an EOD, explosive ordnance disposal team, or a forensics team. Depending on whether there are more explosives present or if there's just craters and bomb debris. So IEDs have the effect of both limiting where patrols can go, making movements that are possible extremely risky, and exacting a high price for every mile you traverse, and then also slowing everyone down because every IED ends up being an hour's long process of recovering the casualties, dragging the vehicle out of the crater, and then investigating the blast site to try to determine what happened and who was responsible. It just goes on and on and on to the point where the war in certain provinces of Afghanistan is basically an IED-centric fight. The major weapon, and most of what Americans and allied soldiers do, is an attempt at countermeasures. So what's left after
ground penetrating radar, looking for geometric shapes, chemical analysis for bombs and steel. Don't tell me you can't come up with that, US government. Supposed to be the smartest bastards out there kicking ass. If we're gonna be kicking ass.
Freelance video journalist. journalist David Axe was embedded with the U.S. Army in Afghanistan in March and April, his fourth trip to Afghanistan. He's a regular contributor to C-SPAN, Wired, and The Washington Times. You can watch this program and others like it on our website if you go to cspan.org and click on Video Library.
There you go. TV 0039 out.